Hello Cloud Gurus, I'm Nigel Poulton, and in this month's episode of Kubernetes This Month, we'll have a bit of a dive into the new Docker subscription plan that's got a lot of people confused. Plus, I'll share with you my top three picks and announcements from the past month. And while you're here, be sure to subscribe to the show so you're always up to date with everything going on in the world of Kubernetes. Okay, so here's the headline. Docker Desktop, which is massively used by organizations all over the world, is not free anymore if you're a large business. Now, we'll define large in a second, but I think the most important thing for you right now is that if you're a personal user, or if you're in education or a small business, then nothing changes. It is still free for you. But if you are a large business, yes, things are changing. So I guess I ought to define what Docker classes as a large business. Basically, if you employ over 250 people and you're doing over 10 million a year in revenue, US dollars, Docker thinks you're big and you need to start paying. And I'll be honest, I wholeheartedly agree with them. I mean, it's a slick product and people are getting value from it every day. So it's only right that we should be paying. Like, if we all just keep using it for free, eventually it won't be there anymore and none of us want that. In fact, I'm a big believer that a healthy Docker is good for just about all of us. Anyway, if you do fall into that big business like you employ over 250 people and do over 10 million a year in revenue category, then you've got the choice of three plans: Pro, Team, and Business. And prices start as low as $5 a month per user for the Pro account, it's $7 a month for the Team plan, and $21 for Business. Now, obviously, you get different benefits depending on which plan you go for, like we're showing here, and the link is down below. Now, Docker Business is a new subscription category, and it's aimed at organizations that want that little bit more control over their Docker development environments. So what you'll get with that is a centralized control plane and the ability to control things like which registries your developers use and which images and versions, and better control over security and a bunch more. So yeah, if you're small or in education, you can keep using Docker for free under the personal plan, but if you're big, do the right thing and start paying. Okay, so time for my picks of the month. Number one, EKS Anywhere. So Amazon are bringing their popular Elastic Kubernetes service to on-prem data centers. And I guess if you're an existing EKS user and you've got your own data centers, then maybe it makes sense to consolidate your Kubernetes management plane onto EKS, because that's effectively what you'll get. I think, as the name suggests, it'll be just like normal EKS, only in your own data center. So the same deployment model and tooling, plus a single console to view your cloud-based and your on-prem EKS clusters. And as well though, I suppose even if you're not an existing EKS user, but maybe you're evaluating distros, so to speak, well, the fact that you can now have the EKS experience and the tooling on-prem and in the cloud, I guess that may make EKS more appealing to you, which is obviously what Amazon are wanting here. Number two, the NGINX Ingress controller goes version 1.0 or GA. So Ingress in general has made some massive moves in recent versions of Kubernetes. Well, this time the popular NGINX Ingress controller, that also finally goes 1.0 or GA. And it's a big step in a couple of areas. Number one, it shows commitment from the project and we like to see that. But also, this is a breaking change. So it only works with Kubernetes 1.19 and higher, and it depends on the V1 API within the networking.kubernetes.io API subgroup. So no more V1 Beta 1. Now there's a bunch more to it than that, but the link that you'll find in the description has another link out to the migration docs, and they are definitely worth the read if you're planning on using it. Number three, security company Snyk goes from strength to strength. So this is last, but it is by no means least. Security company Snyk just raised a very tidy $300 million in a Series F round of funding, taking their valuation to a whopping, and wait for this, $8.5 billion. That is billion with a B. So congratulations to the team at Snyk. The market's obviously loving what they're doing, giving developers ownership of security and making it simple. And I know I've said this a lot before, but organizations are not messing about with security these days, so neither should you. And tools and partners like Snyk are really pushing the needle. Well, that's it for this month's edition of Kubernetes This Month. If you liked the episode, you can check out more of our original series with an ACG free plan. You'll also get access to our learning paths and new courses and quizzes every month. But the best thing is, you don't even need a credit card to sign up. Check out the link below. Stay safe, and I'll see you all again next month. Same Kube time, same Kube place.